welcome to Delivering Miracles, a podcast to teach women like you tips and strategies on how you can have a safer pregnancy so you can bring home a healthy baby. I'm your host and your high-risk pregnancy expert, Barija Deshpande. I can't wait to chat with you. Okay, so can we all just agree that telling a couple to just relax is the least helpful, probably worst advice you could give when they are struggling to get pregnant? Can we just get that out of the way and just be like, okay, yes, yes, we're in agreement with that? Okay, great. Because I am about to do an entire episode right now on essentially what you need to know about fertility trauma as it pertains to your journey to get pregnant. And part of the reason I wanted to get that out of the way is because there's a difference between, hey, just relax, just go to the beach, go take a vacation, you'll get pregnant, and actual physiological relaxation. Okay, there's a complete, total difference between the two. And that's why I wanted to start there, right? We're totally in agreement. This is not just relax, right? But here's where this all comes together. I want to talk to you about fertility trauma because this is showing up a lot. This year alone, 100% of my private clients have experienced fertility trauma. And that got me thinking, this is clearly something we have not talked about. And it's not because, I don't want to talk about it because it's an emotional issue that's important. No, what I'm going to share with you is why it's important to address in order for you to get pregnant and stay pregnant. Okay. If you've been listening to Delivering Miracles at all, if you've been following me on social, if you've read Pregnancy Brain, if you know anything about me, you know that I'm all about the mind-body connection. It's not some fluid, fluffy thing where we're going, yeah, we're one, we're whole, we're holistic. I'm waving my hands around. You can probably imagine. It's not like that. It is actually physiology. The way our brains are structured, the way our body is set up, the way that our certain organs are placed next to each other, all of that is done on purpose because we cannot separate emotional health from physical health. And this is never more important, I believe, than when we are trying to grow our family, especially if you're going down a path that is requiring a lot of medical intervention, like I did, right? You're in this world of ultrasounds and blood work and needles and shots, and it could not be more physically taxing. And yet there is no connection to, hey, what else could be affecting our fertility that's outside of our quote-unquote body? It's all the same. It's one body. It's not like we have two parts of our body that float around next to each other, right? But there's such a delineation between physical health and emotional health, and it drives me nuts. And when I explain to you all of this that I've got for you today, you will see why. And I hope you will join me in the head banging on the wall, or more productively, I hope you will join me in seeing what's possible for your fertility when we actually include trauma resolution as a part of fertility treatment. Okay, so let's jump in. What the heck is fertility trauma? I want to explain this to you in the form of an example that I think you will be able to relate to. Have you ever been driving down a road? You're on the freeway, you're on your neighborhood street, wherever you are, and from the corner of your eye, you see a car that might be coming into your lane and could potentially hit you. You've had that experience, right? I think most of us who drive have. If you don't drive, if you live in one of those incredible cities where you don't have to drive, you might be on a bus and you might have noticed that, or you might be walking and you see a car possibly coming too close to the crosswalk as you're going. Something like that, right? What happens? Your heart stops, right? Or at least that's what we call it, our heart stops, right? But, you know, you have this sense of fear. Your heart starts racing, actually, is what happens physiologically, right? Your breath shallows, you start sweating, right? You get this urge, you know, we'll take the car example, you grab onto the steering wheel really tightly and you swerve out of the way, right? Think of what just happened to your body. You were just driving along merrily. Everything was fine. Maybe you're singing to the song on the radio. You're at baseline, right? And then imagine a line graph, if you will, that your entire body just kind of goes all the way up when you think you're about to get hit, right? Everything gets heightened. And you swerve out of the way, to get yourself to safety. And you notice a car drives by, it's out of the way, there's space for you to get back on the road. And then what happens? You slowly come back. You notice your heart rate kind of dropping a little bit. You loosen your grip on the steering wheel. Start taking more intentional breaths. And then you start processing, what the heck was that? Or maybe cursing the driver. But language comes back, right? And over the course of several minutes, you come back down to baseline. And before you know it, you're turning up the radio again. You're singing and you're on your way. We can all, most of us at least, can relate to some version of that example, right? That is the natural stress cycle. That is stress. Okay, we'll do a whole other episode on what stress is and is not, but that is what it is. There, episode done. That is the stress cycle, that you're at baseline, your body goes zoom, all the way up to get you to safety, and then it comes back down when the threat is gone. Okay. How does that pertain to fertility trauma? Well, what that tells us is, well, let me back up for a second. What is trauma then? Trauma is when you have, you're at baseline and you go zoom, and everything goes all the way up, right? Because there's a threat and you don't get the coming back down. And there are a lot of reasons why that can happen. Tons of reasons. There might not be time because something else is going on. You might be sedated because of surgery and recovering from surgery. You might not have the resources to be able to do that. You might not know how to do that in the sense of how do I get out of my own way to do that, right? And I don't mean that in a blameworthy way. It's there's a lot going on, right? Our bodies are built to do that, to come back down on its own. The parasympathetic nervous system, that is its job. That is its job. That is the only job it has, is to complete that stress cycle. When we get stuck, there are reasons why. You may not have support to do that, right? I mean, this in its own could be a separate podcast episode, but for whatever reason that are not reasons of blame, it is not your fault, not at all your fault, we get stuck at the top. Now, how does that relate to fertility trauma? Getting back to that. Well, one, this tells us that trauma is not based on an event. And what I mean by that is anything can be traumatic. It does not have to be life-threatening. It can be the fact that you have to do treatment. It can be taking shots every night. It can be going into surgery. It can be experiencing a loss. It can be so many different things. And I really want you to hear that, because there's no such thing as traumatic enough. No such thing. Doesn't exist. And you can see why now, right? Because it is literally a cascade of physical reactions. And if taking shots does that to you and you don't get that come down release, that's trauma. If walking into a doctor's appointment does that to you, if doing an ultrasound does that to you, that is trauma. And I think it's really important to hit that home, because I think that's part of the reason why this is going unnoticed, is because we try to justify to ourselves, well, I mean, I had a miscarriage, but I only had one. It's not like my friend who had five, or it's not like my other friend who had an ectopic pregnancy and almost died. No. The event doesn't matter. It's how it gets encoded into your body that matters, right? Following me so far? So that is what we mean by fertility trauma. It can be anything. Anything that takes you from baseline to zoom all the way up. You're going to hear that. You're going to hear my voice with that noise every time you go to your doctor's appointment now. You go all the way up, right? Just like you're trying to swerve away from the car and you don't get that release. What does that look like? What does that look like? Well, it's hard sometimes to notice, because if you've been stuck up there for a long time, months or years, you might not even know that it could be different. But it looks like a lot of different things. You might become really hypervigilant to changes in your body, especially when you're cycling. This happens, you know, there's a lot of changes happening, and you might be super, super sensitive to noticing all the changes, and every change brings anxiety, right? That's one that I see often with clients. Another one is one I see super often, feeling like you can't slow down. Like, you just have to go, go, go. And I got to plan this and I got to do that and I got to get this on the calendar and I got to figure this out. And oh my gosh, we can't figure out the transfer date because we have to wait till for all these things to align. And oh my gosh, I got to, that feeling. You know what I'm talking about, right? You got to fill your calendar. You got to fill your to-do list. You can't stop, right? Another one I see really frequently for my clients is constantly planning for things to go wrong. Negative pregnancy tests, preparing for future cycles, even though you're in the middle of one right now and you don't know how it's going to go. But okay, well, if I'm cycling right now, then that means around Christmas time, we'll be cycling again without knowing what the outcome is, right? Preparing yourself for losses before they have even happened, before you even know you're pregnant, bracing yourself for that. I find a lot of women who are holding on to fertility trauma breathe really shallow during ultrasounds, almost like they're holding their breath. Some of them actually are holding their breath. You might notice that next time. Another one that kind of gives it away is this deep, deep fatigue and exhaustion. And it's more than what you expect from hormones. Like, you know, that's going to mess with your body a bunch, but there's just this deep core, just exhaustion that's there. It doesn't matter what you do. You can drink as much coffee as you want. You can exercise, you can take vitamin D, you can get good sleep, do good high sleep hygiene, all that's there. You might even be on sleep aids and it's just, you're just exhausted, right? Those are a lot of different ways that this can show up for you. And you might, maybe you're listening to this going, oh my gosh, that's me. I want to remind you again, anything can be traumatic. Anything can be encoded in your body as trauma. Because if you look back and go, well, I didn't experience any, it's nothing that bad. We've just been cycling after cycle, one after another, after another, after another. Nothing's really happened. It's kind of the problem. Nothing's happened. Something about that process went from baseline to zoop, all the way up, and you didn't get to complete that stress cycle. That coming down back to baseline didn't happen. That's trauma. That's what we're talking about. Now, why is this so important? What's the point of this, right? I don't need one more thing. I already have PCOS and endometriosis and adenomyosis and my husband has some type of something we're trying to figure out and I don't need one more thing. I hear you. You don't need one more thing. But this is not one more thing. This is something that's already been happening in the background that nobody's addressing. Likely nobody's addressing. If you're listening to this and really nodding along, it's possible nobody in your sphere is addressing this. It's important because, as I said at the beginning of all this, this is not a mental health issue. Whether you are diagnosed with PTSD or not, and that is between you and your licensed mental health provider or psychiatrist, regardless of your diagnosis, this is not a mental health issue. Because when that stress response occurs, right, that moment when you think you're going to get hit by the car and you have that moment, right, but when you're there, and then also when you get stuck there, there are actual changes to your body that happen. Because if you think about it, if you're trying to swerve away from the car, at that moment, the only thing that matters is that you survive, right? And we're talking about an incident that occurs in the span of what, maybe 10 seconds? But let's slow that 10 seconds down a bit and let's see what's happening in those 10 seconds. Because those 10 seconds is where you are stuck. So it is not 10 seconds anymore. It is now 10 weeks or 10 months or maybe 10 years. Entirely possible, right? In those 10 seconds, your body and your brain's only responsibility, the only thing it is doing, the only thing, okay? Really hear that. The only thing it is doing is keeping you alive. And it happens so fast and it happens completely out of our conscious awareness because our conscious thought is not available to us at that time, right? Can you imagine sitting there, you think the car is going to come and you sit there and you go, should I swerve? Should I go left? Should I go right? I'm not really sure where to go. What would have happened by then? Bam, the car would have hit you, right? So there are actual changes to the way our brains work that bypass conscious thought. We are not making pro-con lists and deciding things at that time. We are getting the heck out of the way. And it feels like a reflexive action. The processes go so fast, totally under our conscious awareness and we get out of the way to be safe, right? And it, let's say you swerved left and then you saw another car coming from that side. Then you'd swerve right again, right? Your body will, your brain, your whole system is going to figure it out. But guess what is deprioritized in those moments? Everything else, everything. Digestion stops, completely stops. Wound healing stops. Any priority to any of our reproductive organs stops. You get my point? Right? It makes sense. Why would any of that be necessary when you're trying to escape a threat? And again, the threat can be anything when we're talking about fertility trauma. It can happen in the moment you are injecting yourself at night, right? It can be anything. Now, the problem with fertility trauma is it's not a 10-second experience. It happens. That initial moment that it happened was likely 10 seconds, maybe slightly more, but it was very short. The problem is we get stuck at the top, right? And in being stuck, all the changes that happen in our body in the 10 seconds to escape the car are now going on for days and weeks and months and years. And that is when we see health complications. We see elevated blood glucose levels. We see heart disease. We see wonky blood work that makes no sense. You're young. You're fit. The blood work doesn't match. We see very high levels of inflammation. So much inflammation, because that's what happens in our bodies for those 10 seconds. But in the case of the car accident or the potential car accident, is after the 10 seconds are over, we come back down. And in coming back down, we reestablish balance. The inflammation goes down, wound healing begins again, blood flow comes back onto different parts of our brain as well as different body systems that can receive attention again. See what I'm saying? But when we're stuck, that doesn't happen. The number one thing that I hear from clients when we start doing this work of bringing them back down, resolving that trauma and facilitating that coming downness that didn't happen, the number one thing I hear is, I can think clearly again. I mean, never mind that they completely look like different people, right? Their body is completely relaxed. Their face is really relaxed. There's this light that's illuminating from the inside. But the number one thing I hear is, I can think clearly again. That's what happens. That's what happens. Because now conscious thought is back online. And that's not to say you're not thinking, right? You're clearly thinking. You're holding down a job and maybe you have other kids or you've got other responsibilities. You're making plans. You're going on vacations. You're doing things. You're coordinating fertility cycles, which takes a lot of thought, right? But it also, when you're in that stuck state at the top, all of that effort takes so much energy. You're like overriding something that is trying to stay off because your body's like, no, we don't need this. We need to stay alive. And you're going, no, but I gotta make these plans and do this presentation. And so you're overriding something that's trying to stay offline. And yeah, you can do it. It's likely less efficient than before. You probably noticed it's like harder to think, or it just feels like it gets really overwhelming so much faster than it used to. Like, I used to be able to do 3 presentations at one time. I had 3 different laptops open. I can do it all at one time and I'd be done in 2 hours. And now I can hardly do one in 45 minutes, right? That's the thing about the human body. For better or for worse, we can still make it happen. But what is the downside of that? What is it doing to our bodies to override all of this? Instead of going back to where it all started. That moment when we went zoom and it went all the way up, our whole body just activated to get us to safety and we didn't get the release. And to really bring it all full circle, all of these physical changes that happen when we are stuck at the top cascade down to fertility potential and conception rates. There are tremendous number of studies that show when we are able to actually reactivate that system that brings us back down, conception rates go significantly higher. And that is not because you're relaxing on the beach, but because you are activating a built-in relaxation system. It is not just a relaxation system, it's a repair system. It's fixing all the damage that's been happening in our bodies by being stuck up there. And one of the effects of that is improved fertility rates. That's how stress and fertility work together. That's what that means. So when you hear people say, well, don't stress, just relax, stop stressing out so much, that has nothing to do with it. That's completely missing the boat. Because do you hear what I have not said all this time? There's one huge piece that keeps getting thrown into the mix here that I haven't even touched on. Your thoughts. That stress cycle has nothing to do with your thoughts. Those negative thoughts that we end up having going, I'm never going to get pregnant. My body's broken. I'm a failure. This sucks. What if we never have kids? What if we never have more kids? What if this doesn't work out? What if my partner leaves me? Oh my God. Like all those, that's a side effect of being stuck. And if you really want to nerd out with me for a second, you know how I said the only goal of your body at that in those 10 seconds is to get to safety, right? And conscious thought is not one of them, because if you sat there and thought about it, you'd get hit. So you don't think, right? You're not supposed to. It's not a flaw of yours. You're not supposed to. It's to keep you alive. That's why we don't think in those moments. When we are stuck in that spot and we have all these negative thoughts, we think, if we can flip those thoughts, I'll feel better, right? We try affirmations, we try mantras, we go to CBT therapists, we go to life coaches, we try worksheets, right? It's not going to work. You know that. You know that. You've tried it. It doesn't work, because that's not the problem. Your thoughts are not the problem. The problem is you're stuck feeling unsafe because you keep thinking you're going to get hit by a car. And so in those moments, all those thought parts of our brain go offline. Again, not to say you don't have thoughts. You need thoughts. You need language to get through your day. You are talking all the time. I believe it. I know it. But the amount of energy that it takes to do that and get through your day is so much more than when we are not stuck at the top. And you probably already feel that. You just feel more tired lately, don't you? More run down. I just want to sleep. I just want to go to sleep. I just want to rest. My brain feels tired, right? It's exactly what's happening. That's literally exactly biologically what's happening. That's exactly it. And so all those cognitive approaches don't work because there's nothing wrong with your thoughts. Mind-blowing, isn't it? Like, oh my gosh, I've been totally looking the wrong way. And if you're not completely convinced, let me give you one visual to take with you. I like to talk about being chased by a bear, right? If you've read Pregnancy Brain, talk about that a lot. Because I find that example to be far enough out there that most of us have not encountered it in real life. So we can step back and kind of look at it, right? Affirmations, mantras, CBT, any type of cognitive tools to try to improve and flip your negative thoughts to positive ones as you are going through this. If you recognize that you are actually stuck, you have this fertility trauma, you realize you haven't, maybe you haven't even called it fertility trauma. Maybe you're calling yourself stressed out. Totally fine. You're trying all these cognitive tools. I want you to imagine doing that as you're running away from a bear. You see the bear and you go, I'm out of here. I'm out of here. I'm a good person. I can do this. I deserve to be a mother. It's ridiculous, right? You would never do that. It would not help you get away from the bear, right? That's why those techniques don't stick. Because when you're stuck at the top, right? You're at baseline, something happens that makes you feel scared that something's going to happen to you. So you go all the way up. It does not actually have to be life-threatening. Something, right? Taking shots, going to an ultrasound, being in the waiting room, getting a call from the doctor. And instead of that happening and then coming back down, you get stuck up there for some reason, any number of reasons. In that time, your body and brain's number one goal is to keep you alive. Telling yourself you're a good person is not conducive to that. I'm being facetious on purpose because I want you to see that it's not you. Because here's the thing. I would probably say 99% of my clients, probably 100 if I actually sat down and looked at it, have all tried these things and nothing has worked. And then they come to me either through a referral or self-referral or something, and they have this laundry list of things that they have tried, and I just want to get pregnant, and I know that my stress is affecting my body, but I just want to be more positive, and I just want to do this. I just want to get pregnant, right? That's the state they come in, whatever their history might be. It's usually a very dark history, very, very hard times they have been through. And they've tried all of this, and they feel like they're so broken. Like, I can't get pregnant. I have been through all the things, right? Miscarriage, ectopic pregnancy, stillbirth, preterm delivery, recurrent pregnancy loss, any number of things. I've almost died, right? Any number of things. Couldn't do that. I am trying to get pregnant again. Here I go again. Can't do that either. And now I can't even be positive? This blows. What is wrong with me? That's the state they come in. So if you find yourself in that state and you're going, I'm throwing everything at this and I can't even do that, this is why I'm doing this podcast episode. I want you to understand the physiology of this. There's so much advice out there about what to do and what not to do. But I find for myself, if I understand what my body's doing, I will understand what I need to do to help it. And I hope you now see that cognitive tools, positive affirmations are not helpful when you are stuck at the top. They are fantastic tools to use at other times of your healing process, but not when you're stuck there and your body thinks it's going to be eaten by a bear or hit by a car. It won't work. There's no amount of effort you can put in. You can sit there 24 hours a day with whatever tools you have to change your thoughts. They won't work. You'll get relief for 5 minutes, maybe an hour, maybe a day if you're lucky. It'll all fall apart again. And that's not because of you. It's just addressing the wrong part of the healing journey at the wrong time. That's all it is. That's all it is. I have been waving my hands wildly. You can't see me. There's a reason I don't do videos with my podcast. I feel so strongly about this. You know, if you have been following me, we have had a very tumultuous fertility journey. We are very lucky to have two living children at the end of it. But there is so much that is out of our control. There's so much heartbreak. There's so many reasons to grieve, so many losses, death and non-death losses. I know this road so well. I remember it like it was yesterday. My daughter is not even one yet. She hasn't even been in the world as long as she had been in utero. She certainly has not been in the world as long as she's been in the freezer, right? Since she'd been created. We're just barely on the other side. And I remember it. I know it. It wasn't even a year ago. We were in it. And I find it so much more empowering to understand some piece of it, right? It gives back control and power a little bit. Oh, that's why that's not working. Oh, that's what my body is trying to tell me. Is it going to be a cure to infertility? No, but nothing is. Even the fertility treatment you're doing right now is not a cure. What we're doing is stacking the deck in your favor. And including trauma resolution has to be part of that. Because I hope you now see this is so much more than being quote unquote stuck in the past or having trouble letting things go or being too negative, doing air quotes that you also can't see. It's not about that. It is about a chain reaction that happens in our bodies in order to keep us safe that doesn't stop. It doesn't stop. And so you're stuck there constantly looking for safety. Your brain, your body, as you are going about your day and you're scheduling appointments and you're going to plan new cycles and planning your vacations and going to work and all that, in the background, your body's going, yeah, but we're going to get hit by that car. Now, does it make sense how exhausting that is and why you're so overwhelmed so quickly and why you're so tired all the time? Look at how much you're doing at one time. And it's not just your experience of it. That chain reaction that happens in your body affects your reproductive system. So then the question naturally is, well, then does stress cause infertility? No. No, it does not. Because stress is not, number one, stress is not the problem. If you notice and you remember what that stress cycle is like, you go zoop up. That's the stress response that's on. And then the full response is then to come back down. So going up isn't the problem. It's the missing the going down part that results in health issues. right? And there's no one cause for this, but it is a big time player that could be one of the root causes for something you are going through. The inflammation that comes from it, the blood glucose imbalances that come from it, the changes to so many different body systems, the hypertension that comes from it, the anovulation that happens because of it, the irregular periods that are supposed to be like that because this is supposed to be a 10-second experience that has now gone on for weeks, months, or years. And I so strongly believe that is the reason why every single one of my clients who cycles with me when we do this work gets pregnant. It's not magic. It's just the missing piece. They've been playing a 100-piece puzzle with 99 pieces. And finally, we get that last piece in, and guess what happens? You need all those 99 pieces. Don't get me wrong. I'm not saying work with me and you never have to see a reproductive endocrinologist again. Please. I am not that naive or that egotistical. But it is a puzzle. I want you to see it like that. That's what we're talking about here. So when you hear, just relax, it'll be fine. Now you know why that's wrong on so many levels. It's not only just the worst advice ever and it's not helpful, it's also physiologically wrong. Because you can be all the way at the top, even at the beach, right? It doesn't have to do with your surroundings. You'll get temporary relief at best. What you need is to come back down. And so how do you do that? That's the work that I specialize in. And it involves re-regulating your nervous system. It's like going to your thermostat in your house going, oh, we don't need it to be set at 900 degrees. Let's turn it down a little so that the air stops flowing and it can get a break, right? And there are a lot of ways to do that. There are a lot of ways to do that. You can try breath work. I'm cautious to recommend that because there are several of my clients who find breathing to be triggering, especially some of my clients who have had, when their trauma was encoded, it was after a surgery. An emergency surgery often, right? And so they remember that sensation of being forced to breathe deeply and it just kind of triggers this other reaction. So you got to listen to your body, right? Breath work for some is great. In for a count of four or five, out for double. Beautiful. It's fantastic, right? Progressive relaxation. So amazing. So powerful. Takes about 15, 20 minutes. Start from your head all the way down to your toes. You tighten muscles for like a count of five and then relax them with an exhale all the way through. Super powerful. Something even as simple as dropping your shoulders, right? But what I want you to hear is this is not cognitive work. What this is retraining your body. It's like going to the gym to relearn that you are safe, right? Any number of these things that work on your body that help your nervous system turn off, your arousal system turn off so that the repair system can turn back on and you can come back down the other side from being all the way at the top, right? When that happens, all the symptoms you're feeling are going to get better, if not go away. And ideally, you will get pregnant, including all the other 99 pieces that are required to do that. You've got to start with regulating your nervous system. Breath work, progressive relaxation, dropping your shoulders, stretching, right? When we're up there at the top, we're tight. You remember when you're swerving out of the way, how hard you grip that steering wheel, that tightness stays for weeks, months, and years. Maybe it's just not in your hands anymore, but it's somewhere. All of that matters. All of that matters. And that's what I specialize in. And that's why it's so powerful, because it follows physiology. We're not slapping band-aids on things trying to get you to feel better. We're trying to get to the root cause, to get you back to safety, to teach your body that car isn't here anymore. You are safe. And in doing that, you see changes to your immune system, your nervous system, your endocrine system, all of which are necessary to help you get pregnant. And the work is actually so powerful that even if you require fertility treatment of any kind, injections all the way through IVF, those results get better. And I believe that that's possible for anybody. We can't predict anything. But I do believe that if we follow our physiology and we follow our bodies and we give it what it needs, right? Because your body's not trying to fight you. It's not trying to stay up here. It sucks to stay up here. It sucks on so many levels to be stuck at the top. So it is trying to come back down and it just has gotten stuck. And if we can facilitate that repair to come back down to baseline, so much gets better. We see changes to blood work. We see changes to ultrasound. Periods become regular for some people where this was one of their symptoms, right? Whatever it is that's thrown off balance that causes some of these symptoms, those symptoms get better. It's amazing. It's amazing and is tremendously powerful. And if you want to learn more about it, you can check out the Optimize Your Fertility workshop to learn more about the details and the research behind all of this and how it pertains specifically to fertility. And there's a guided somatic exercise that I've done with our participants there that you can follow along with. Or if you're just done DIYing it and you're like, I'm in, I really just want to do this, then I would suggest joining the Path to Baby program, which is personalized support, completely customized to you, following your physiology to help you prepare for pregnancy. And the link for both is in the show notes below. So you're welcome to check that out and see which one's right for you and reach out, because it works. And it's not because it's magic, and it's not because it's me or I'm teaching some kind of amazing formula that I created. It is literally following physiology. If we understand what's happening in our bodies, we can undo it the right way and we can start to see results. It needs to be simple. I'm impatient. I assume you are too, right? You're tired of fighting. Let's just get you to where you want to go. Why does it have to be hard? You've already done hard. Let's make this part simple. That's what I think anyway. Ah, there you have it. Fertility drama. I could go on about this forever. I would love to know what you think. So let me know. Email me. Does this resonate? Do you have questions? So far, every time I've explained it like this before I recorded this, it's like a light bulb has gone on. They're going, oh, that makes sense. That makes like there's something I understand that's happening in my body. And it's maybe you can track it back to a moment or moments that you had. Go, oh, that's when I got stuck. That's when I was stuck up there. I've been stuck there for, and then you kind of realize how long it's been, right? But there's an illumination that comes from that when this is not this amorphous, just don't stress. Oh my gosh, stop saying that. It's not like that. It's like, I said this to somebody the other day. It's like if you're telling somebody not to stress when they are going through infertility, it's like asking them not to be hungry when they haven't eaten. That's how powerful this is. That's how body-driven this is, right? Ooh, yeah. So the next time somebody says, just relax, you're welcome to walk away now for multiple reasons, not just because they're being unhelpful. It's just not even physiologically true and accurate what they're saying. Thank you so much for joining me here today. I hope this resonated. I hope this was illuminating for you and educational and inspiring and empowering to show you there is more you can do, that you're not stuck here on this cog in this machine, just waiting for your turn, hoping for the best. We don't know what the outcome is going to be. Nobody can guarantee that. Neither can your doctor. Nobody can predict that. But I really believe that if we can get more pieces of that puzzle together, outcomes can improve. And I'm really hopeful for that, for you too. Check out the Optimize Your Fertility workshop if you want to learn a little bit more, or if you're just ready to jump right in and get that personalized support. Check out the Path to Baby program. I would love for you to join us. The links are below. And I would love to stay connected. So follow me on Instagram at healthy.highriskpregnancy and come say hi. I love meeting my new followers. So let me know you're there. It's not you. You've done nothing wrong. You're not weak. You're not broken. You're not a failure. I know you're telling yourself that. I know sometimes you really believe it. I've been there. But our bodies are telling a different story. They're telling us the story of what we've been through, when it got really, really hard, and the kind of support that we need to heal from it in order to go back to functioning as optimally as we can. Our job is only to listen, pay attention, trust it, and get out of the way. It really is that simple. It's not easy. It's simple. And it is massively powerful. And I know that when you are able to do that, with my support or not, When you're able to do that, there's a tremendous sense of peace that will come over you, regardless of your outcome. And what more can we ask for than that when we have no idea what lies ahead? Take it one day, one step at a time. You can do this.